From JBS Studios in Greater New York, this is the JBS News Update with Teisha Bader.
I'm Teisha Bader with the JBS News Update for Tuesday, October the 6th, 2020. A rocket was fired last night from Gaza at southern Israel. The projectile is believed to have landed in an open area. No damage or injury was caused. In response, the IDF tweeted that late last night, Israeli aircraft struck a Hamas target in Gaza, writing, "We will protect Israeli civilians from terror." The foreign ministers of Israel and of the United Arab Emirates met in Germany today, their first in-person meeting. Gabi Ashkenazi and Sheikh Abdullah bin Zayed Al Nahyan sat down together at a government guest house just outside the capital of Berlin, along with German Foreign Minister Heiko Maas, who said it was a great honor that the Israeli and Emirati foreign ministers have chosen Berlin as the location for their historic first meeting, which of course follows the historic signing last month of the Abraham Accords in Washington, the normalization of ties between Israel and the UAE. Maas called the peace agreement courageous, and at the same time, he said, an opportunity for new movement in the dialogue between Israel and the Palestinians. "We must seize this opportunity," he said, "and Germany and Europe want to help." Maas added, "I hope that Berlin can offer a good framework to discuss further steps on this path." Ashkenazi and Al-Nahyan and Maas later visited the Berlin Holocaust Memorial. The Emirati minister wrote in the museum's guest book that the visit to the memorial underscored the importance of human values, such as coexistence, tolerance, and accepting the other, as well as respect for all creeds and faiths. He wrote, "I salute the souls of those who fell victim to the Holocaust," writing "Never Again" in English and in Arabic. An Orthodox synagogue in Brooklyn was broken into and vandalized yesterday. Windows were broken and property inside the Shore Parkway Jewish Center was damaged in the attack, as well as the synagogue's sukkah. The New York Police Department's Hate Crimes Task Force is investigating the incident. There was an arrest of a 25-year-old man who was charged with burglary and criminal mischief hate crimes. The Anti-Defamation League's New York, New Jersey office tweeted that they were deeply unsettled by the incident, writing, "This should never happen, but it is painful to see one of our spiritual homes vandalized during the Festival of Sukkot." They also thanked the NYPD Hate Crimes Task Force for swiftly investigating. And in Europe, the Athens Jewish Cemetery in Nikaia, Greece, was defaced Sunday night with anti-Semitic slogans and a Nazi symbol painted on its outer stone wall, including the phrase, "Jews, get out," written in German. Government spokesman Stelios Petsas said Nazism and anti-Semitism and their followers have no place in Greece and will not be tolerated. Foreign Affairs Minister Nikos Dendias said he was saddened and appalled, tweeting, "Nazism and its followers have no place in our society and in any society." The Israeli embassy in Greece called the graffiti heinous, that it is yet another reminder of the existence of evil. They wrote, "Together with many other proud Greek voices, we stand against hate, racism, and extremism based on ignorance and prejudice." Well, today marks 47 years since the outbreak of the Yom Kippur War, October the 6th of 1973, when Syria and Egypt launched surprise coordinated attacks on the holiest day of the Jewish calendar against Israeli positions on the Golan Heights and in the Sinai Peninsula. And while the IDF was ultimately victorious, 2,688 Israeli soldiers lost their lives in battle. Israel's Defense Ministry today released new archival footage, including some never seen before, and now in color, of the war, which includes scenes of soldiers on the Suez Canal, then Southern Command head Ariel Sharon visiting the Egyptian front, female soldiers folding parachutes, and a visit to entertain the troops by veteran actor Chaim Topol. The Defense Ministry said the films were located as part of a digitization project in the IDF archives, allowing for them to be preserved at greater quality levels for future generations. Taking a look now at our programming for tonight on JBS for Tuesday, October the 6th. At 7 o'clock, Michael Singh, Charles Lister, and Javier Buzo discuss Syria after 9 years of war and the implications for Israeli security. That's with Cameron Brown at APAC 2020. At 8, Middle East foreign policy experts Corey Shack, Ben Talablu, and Michael Pregent analyze the new Iran-Iraq relationship of cooperation and discuss the possible threats it poses for the state of Israel, with Joshua Nazon at APEC 2020 as well. At 9, Mark Golub sits down for part 2 of the L'Chaim interview with former chair of the Conference of Presidents, Richard Stone. At 10, Beth Ginsburg talks about the history of Jewish political participation in the U.S. and other world governments. And coming up next, Shachar Azani, JBS Senior Vice President and former member of the Israeli Diplomatic Corps, describes the social and political chaos in Israel caused by the coronavirus pandemic, with Mark Golub on the JBS series Gam Yachad, Together During COVID-19. And that's the JBS News Update for Tuesday, October the 6th, 2020. I'm Teisha Bader. Stay healthy. Stay well.